as an orthopedics professor, as I had mentioned, I always dreamed of being able to not get stuck talking only about the shoulder for shoulder week. I really wanted to talk about the cervical spine a little bit, and the thoracic spine, and the testing and interventions and the therapeutic exercises. I wanted to talk about all of it, but there was never enough time. So, just as a quick glimpse, let me show you. If you go to one of the apps, let's say the orthopedic app, and this will just take 1 minute. When I look at the shoulder joint, every week I use the app with the students. And I'll say, hey, we're going to talk about a bunch of shoulder conditions, just the most common ones. So here's someone with a shoulder impingement. Here's some prevalence data. Everything's linked to the PubMed abstracts. Here's a video that we watched together of someone with an arc of pain, but he has full range of motion. So these are all videos that are narrated. And here's the things that we're going to, if you're in a PTA program, you talk about these are the tests that you're going to see and that you are learning as well. And this is what drives the classification of the patient to a certain extent. All right, so here's all your tests that the students will study, they can watch, they can read. Here's all your research numbers. And by the way, here's some common impairments. So if you look at some common impairments, here are some common impairments that you're gonna see the PT examine. So here are some upper quarter, some medial rotators that are short. We can assess it because I think the value comes because you can link the impairments to the interventions. Now everybody's on the same page, right? So here's my interventions. I need to, from my manual therapy standpoint, improve some glenohumeral joint accessory mobility. Here's the MOBs that you're gonna learn in class. The guy's scapula is not moving very well. Here is a technique to improve scapulothoracic mobility. By the way, I found some soft tissue, the muscles that were short. Well, here are some soft tissue mobilizations that link to your examination of muscle length. So here, these are all videos. And when you think about the interventions from a therapeutic exercise standpoint, which typically in most programs is a separate class, I always invite them to look at it in this moment. I may not get a chance to teach you this yet, but here are some stretches that you're going to learn that are typical. You may already know them. I'm going to teach it to you a quarter later, but I want you to see the whole picture today. So I think this helps with the synthesis. This helps to connect with previously known knowledge. This is what I do at the beginning of every class. I talk through the app to give them a big picture of where all of this information is supposed to land. So let me move on here. So ideas and problems. After you come up with your ideas and problems, all right, so from an orthopedic professor, my problem was I taught everything in isolation. And basically, they knew how to regurgitate everything in isolation. They had no idea that everything was meant to be connected. So I built something that allowed me to show them the connections ahead of time. Before I dumped more and more content on them, they already had the map laid out. My expert thinking was now open on an app that they could revisit ahead of time, during, and after.